35, who the priest of that church is a fan of pool and different sports, and he has everybody playing pool. And they have pool tables everywhere in the White House. I played in the White House many times. And I've just played governors and all different, so I played for every multimillionaire that ever lived. There's no, I never saw, you couldn't mention a multimillionaire I didn't know or I haven't played for.
This is one of the last household names on this planet, is Minnesota Fats. Millions of people would be affected.
Let me ask you about you. I know that you set a record in Guinness's sports on the most billiard balls, I guess, that were sunk in a pocket.
Most balls pocketed in 1974.
Without missing. How many did you sink without missing?
5,688 balls. One ball every 15.19 seconds. Yes. It was a world record. And it was our association with Minnesota Fats to put together a world-class, respectable pool image. And every pool player has come out of retirement. In the last, since 1977, when we did the show at the Waldorf Astoria, we charged $200 a ticket to get in. You couldn't, I mean, everyone was there.
There was 500 people in the foyer waiting to get in. That's a lot of money, $200.
His friends, I just challenge Minnesota Fats friends to reach out to this program that you're on and to help support what TBN, is that the program here? And your show, Tommy Burnett. I came to your church on Sunday and came in. They're so saturated and burned out with the production. And we praise God and rejoice at your ministry. I just want to thank that it was your ministry when I was 12 years old in a little town in Belleville, Ontario, that turned me on, and God laid his hand on my life to begin preaching. It was your ministry, and God has...
Would you like to share a testimony for Christ right to the point here before we go?
If a testimony, I would just sincerely reach out to people that are watching and that are aching and hurting, all walks of life, that why try it? Just reach out to the most simple thing in life. We had a program, Reach Out to Reach In. And if they would reach out to Christ, he would minister to every area of their life, whatever it would be, and bring them peace that you could never find. If you own the biggest home in Phoenix here, if you had the largest bank account at First Interstate Bank, it would not bring you the peace. And you would say, Jesus Christ, take total control of my life.
Bruce, I want to thank you for coming down here and bringing Minnesota Fats. I've watched him many, many times on TV, and Minnesota, I never had any idea that someday I'd get to interview you myself. And you said a while ago that you were not a very religious man. You've been too busy making a living, but I'm sure you won't mind as you go your way if these millions of Christians who watch this program pray a little prayer for you. Would that be okay?
Be fine.
We'll pray for you.
And I'm a funny living creature myself. Yes. See, I believe in the things that you're supposed to believe in, but a lot of people don't. I believe that every living creature should have a chance on this earth, and they don't.
That's right.
And I believe that every living creature should live.
That's right.
You understand? And they don't.
Yes.
And I'm funny. Although I'm not really religious, I wouldn't swat a fly or a bumblebee. I feed 100 dogs and cats every day.
Is that right?
And take care of 100 children every day.
That's okay.
And I feed 1 million birds every day. Mm-hmm. Not every day, but every year.
Yeah.
And I have all the aspects of being a good Christian, but I don't know whether I am or not.
We're going to be talking to this wonderful man, and our prayers are with him. And before he leaves, I want to say to you that, you know, he comes off as kind of a gruff old boy on television when he plays that other gray-headed man. We'll not even mention his name on the
program. Robbed him 100 times when we play for money on television. Everything is short. You see, if Palmer would take a trip around this country and play 4 holes of golf, he could lose 100 times in a row to pros, which he could beat if they played a long session. Mm-hmm. See, now, I had 2 shows. One show was Minnesota Fats Hustles of Pros. Nobody ever got that. It's 2 hours live.
Uh-huh.
2 hours, they can't get there. But the shows that you see is 2 out of 3,
right,
and 3 out of 5. And a child that plays pretty good pool could beat you 1 game or 2 games.
I got a feeling that he's getting kind of set up. That's kind of what's been going on in my mind when I've been watching, that you're kind of setting him up for something. I don't know what it is.
I'm going to take him off very shortly.
We're glad to have you. Thank you very much. Let's give him a real welcome for being on our program here today. What do you think? Thank you very much. We're going to hear from our guest musician, and again, thank you so much, Minnesota Fats, for being with us. And that's one thing about Praise the Lord. You never know what's going to happen on this program. Somebody may pop in here, and of course, being with us today is a legendary figure, and of course, this is not the normal Praise the Lord program that we have here today, but I think you all appreciate what this program is doing and how it's reaching out to people that need the gospel of Christ. And Minnesota Fats has left us to go on his way, but as he expressed that he wasn't a religious man, like you might have noticed the mist in his eyes. We had a chance to talk to him. I believe his heart has really been touched for God here today. And I want you to pray for this notorious man that God will continue to do great things in his life. Thank you for being on the program today. And we're going to hear again from our guest musician. And then we got two more guests. No telling who else will drop in today. So just hang around on Praise the Lord. This was a first for Praise the Lord.
We're back. You know, when you think about a pool shark, you know, people usually think of the guy sitting around, you know, with the smoky pool hall with the bulb hanging down, you know, over there, and these two guys, you know, leaning over in these smoky joints shooting pool. Well, you know, all that's changed now. The game of pool has moved into respectability. And we've got today with us a man who has some amazing shooting techniques, and he's one of the men responsible for generating such a renewed interest into the sport. And we're going to be looking, he's going to be with us in just a moment. But right now, I want you to take a look at some shots done by a man called Superstroke.
This is a big shot. Which made me realize you gotta be that good. You can't get it. There we go. Whoa. Across the street.
And ladies and gentlemen, here is from Richmond, Virginia, Bruce Christopher. Come on in, Bruce. My goodness.
Thank you, Bill.
You know, I was all tuned up to ask you a dumb question. I was going to say, how did you get the nickname Superstroke?
Superstroke.
So much for that dumb question. Good grief. How'd you get started in all this stuff, man?
Started playing pool on my mother's kitchen table when I was 7 years old, took my dad's golf clubs and sawed them off. And then my brother and I started playing pool around Belleville, Ontario, Canada. And the rest is history. It's a great game. It's a great way to relax. There's exercise, bending, stretching, squatting, walking around the pool table, good way to keep in shape. Wonderful way of meeting people. And of course, God has opened up the door to use this as a tool of witness and outreach. And many, many people are finding Christ. We're pastors and ministers.